मेहर पटियार एंड आई एम अ स्टूडेंट ऑफ बेनेक यूनिवर्सिटी. टुडे इन दिस वीडियो वी विल लर्न अबाउट दिक्स्ट्रा एल्गोरिथम. इन दिक्स्ट्रा एल्गोरिथम वी फाइंड द शॉर्टेस्ट पाथ ट्री विद अ गिवन सोर्स. वी मेंटेन टू सेट्स. वन सेट इंक्लूड्स वर्टिसेस व्हिच आर इंक्लूडेड इन द शॉर्टेस्ट पाथ ट्री एंड द अदर सेट हैज वर्टिसेस व्हिच आर नॉट इंक्लूडेड इन द शॉर्टेस्ट पाथ ट्री. In this algorithm, with each step, we take vertices that are not yet included in the shortest path tree and have a minimum distance from the source root. So let's get started. Now, with the help of an example, we will see the approach of Dijkstra algorithm using greedy method. To show this approach, I will first take a simple graph here. Here our source vertex is S and we have to find the shortest path from 1 to 2 and 1 to 3. Here the distance from 1 to 2 is 2 and the direct path here and it is a direct path here. So the cost of 2 is 2 and there is no direct path from 1 to 3, hence the distance for now is infinity. Now, if we follow Dijkstra algorithm, we have to use the shortest path vertex. And Dijkstra says that via that vertex, we have to check the shortest path to other vertices. So here, there is no direct path from 1 to 3, but there is a direct path from 2 to 3. And the cost of 2 is 2, and the distance from 2 to 3 is 4. So we can add them up. And the distance from 1 to 3 can be modified to 6. Which means that there is a shortest path from 1 to 3, but it is not a direct path. It goes via 2. Here 6 is less than infinity, hence the shortest path from 1 to 3 is 6 and the shortest path from 1 to 2 is 2. Now this updation from infinity to 6 is known as relaxation. Here the distance from 1 to 2 can be taken as u and this distance can be taken as v. Now according to relaxation, if distance of u plus cost of u plus v is less than distance of v, then distance of v is equal to distance of u plus cost of u plus v. Now in this graph let us find the shortest path. From 1 to 2 the distance is 2 and from 1 to 3 the distance is 4. So the shortest path between these two is 2. Hence we choose 2. Once we choose the shortest path, now we perform relaxation. Now let us see which vertices are connected to 2. Here 2 is directed towards 4 as well as 3. So first let's check the distance till 4. Cost of 2 is 2 and the distance from 2 to 4 is 7. Now using relaxation we add 2 and 7 which gives us a total of 9. So this infinity can be modified to 9. Similarly here 2 plus 1 is 3 which is less than 4. So this 4 can be modified to 3. Again we find the shortest vertex. Here we find the shortest vertex from between 3, 9, infinity and infinity. So the shortest vertex is 3 here and 5 is the only vertex which is connected to 3. Now let's check. 3 plus 3 gives us a 6 which is less than infinity. So this infinity can be modified to 6. Now here you see that some vertices are relaxed. Now it's not always that all the vertices will be relaxed. They may or may not be relaxed, but we should check for each vertex. Now let's repeat the step and find the shortest vertex between 6, infinity and 9. Here 6 is the 5 is the shortest vertex. So 5 is the shortest vertex and 4 and 6 are connected to 5. Let's check for 4 first. 6 plus 2 gives us an 8, which is less than 9. So this 9 can be modified to 8. Similarly, we check for 6. 6 plus 5 gives us an 11, which is less than infinity. So this infinity can be modified to 11. Now let's follow the same procedure and find the shortest vertex between 4 and 6. Here 4 is the shortest vertex because 8 is less than 11. So let's check for 6. 4, 8 plus 1 gives us a 9, which is less than 11. So this 11 can be modified to 9. Now we have the shortest distance for each and every vertex. Now this can be written in a tabular form. Here V is the vertex. And DV. V is the vertex and DV is the distance, the shortest distance of each vertex. Here we see from 1 to 2 the shortest distance is 2 for vertex 2. For vertex 3, the shortest distance is 3. For vertex 4, we have the shortest distance as 8. For vertex 5, we have the shortest distance as 6. And for vertex 6, we have the shortest distance as 9. Now, this is how Dijkstra algorithm works. We have shown the working of Dijkstra algorithm on a directed graph to find the shortest path. We can also find the time complexity of this graph and the general form. So here, time complexity. Let each vertex be V. This can be written as N. So, for all the vertices, we have find relaxation for all vertices. So, in general, at most, how many vertices are being relaxed? So, this is also V. Now, our time complexity can be written as V into V. And V is N. Therefore, N into N, which is equal to N squared. This can also be written as theta equal to n square. This is our worst case time complexity. Now we have seen the working of Dijkstra algorithm and we have also found the time complexity, the worst case time complexity, that is the maximum number of vertices that are being relaxed. And we can use Dijkstra algorithm to find the shortest path for a non-directed graph as well. I hope I have been able to explain the concept well. Thank you.